Hi, how are you going? I hope you're feeling as well as possible on your medicines. I'm Pharmacist Fi, and this is Denver. Welcome to our Medicine Safety YouTube channel. Today, I'd like to share with you some important ways to try to avoid some risky potential side effects and medicine interactions for a medicine called Colchicine when it is taken for gout. You might know Colchicine by brand names like Colchris or Mitigare or Gloperba in the USA, or brand names like Colgout or Lengout or Colcine in Australia. Please note that this video does not cover everything you need to know about Colchicine for gout, so I'll put links to my other videos with other really important information about Colchicine, plus some videos about gout and other gout medicines into the description section below this video for you. And I highly recommend that you also ask your doctor or pharmacist to please print or email you the latest medicine information for your brand of Colchicine, which will be called a medication guide in the USA or a patient information leaflet in the UK, or a CMI or consumer medicine information in Australia. So when you have that medicine information, you can read that info to find out even more about your medicine, like that Colchicine should be kept well sealed in its container somewhere away from light. Also, because the toxic amount is not a lot higher than the treatment amount of Colchicine, it is very important to keep Colchicine where children and animals cannot access it. Okay, now let's look at potential Colchicine toxicity side effect symptoms to watch out for. And then we'll look at some types of interacting medicines and grapefruit products which we need to avoid taking with Colchicine. Thankfully, with modern dose schedules, most people don't get Colchicine toxicity side effects these days. But the most common potential toxicity side effects of Colchicine are stomach or intestine area pain, diarrhea, nausea, vomiting, or a combination of some of these things. And the Australian CMI for Colchicine advise that if you get any of these symptoms, stop taking Colchicine immediately, even if your gout pain has not been fully relieved yet. Personally, if I got any of these symptoms from Colchicine, I would also contact a doctor immediately for advice on whether anything else needs to be done or not. Because, as you'll see shortly, severe versions of these same symptoms are among the list of serious Colchicine toxicity symptoms for which you would need emergency medical attention. A doctor will usually tell you to stop taking Colchicine for at least 3 days after getting a side effect like stomach or intestine area pain, diarrhea, nausea, or vomiting. But in some cases, they might advise stopping for longer. For example, if you have a kidney or liver problem, or if you've accidentally taken something that interacts with Colchicine. Also, tell your doctor if you experience any of the less common potential side effects from Colchicine, like loss of appetite or loss of hair from your head or body. This next list of Colchicine's uncommon but serious toxicity symptoms for which you would need to seek emergency medical attention if you get one or more of these symptoms are unusual bleeding or bruising, increased tendency to infections, fever, feeling weak or fatigued, muscle pain or weakness, numbness or tingling in the fingers or toes, a raw or burning feeling in the throat, stomach or intestine area, severe vomiting or diarrhea, which may or may not have red or black blood in it, difficulty urinating or blood in urine, which may look pink or red, urine is pee or wee, feeling confused, delirium, seizures of fits or convulsions, a pale or grey colour of the lips, tongue or palms of hands, itchy skin rash or hives. Thanks to new treatment guidelines for gout in recent years, a lot of doctors are now prescribing modern, smaller Colchicine dose schedules to achieve a similar reduction of gout flare, inflammation and pain, but thankfully with much less risk of getting Colchicine toxicity side effects. And I'll put some info about this into the description section of this video. Colchicine has a range of different types of interactions, but the most risky type involves a particular type of medicine or herb or grapefruit juice blocking an enzyme in our liver and intestines called CYP3A4 and or blocking an important little transporter in our liver and intestines called P-glycoprotein, which may also be called MDR1. And this P-glycoprotein transporter and CYP3A4 enzyme normally help our body to get rid of Colchicine. So blocking them gives us a risk of getting too high a level of Colchicine in our body, which may then cause toxicity. And in the case of Colchicine, toxicity means reducing how well our cells work, including some important types of immune system cells, liver and kidney cells, muscle cells, nerve and brain cells, and more, and reducing our ability to make new cells, which is essential for staying alive. For example, people have died from taking the standard dose schedule of Colchicine with the standard dose schedule of either the antibiotic clarithromycin or the immune system suppressing medicine cyclosporin, because these medicines strongly block both our CYP3A4 enzyme and our P-glycoprotein transporter. I will now give you a list of some types of medicines which may also interact with colchicine in a similar way. And please note that this list does not include every medicine that interacts in this way, so make sure you ask your doctor or pharmacist for a medicine interaction check before starting colchicine. And also, ask for a medicine interaction check before starting any new medicines or health products if you are already taking colchicine. If you need to take any of the medicines in this list, then you must not take colchicine, unless in some cases a doctor might significantly change your colchicine dose schedule to manage the medicine interaction. And for some people, a specialist doctor may be needed to do this. For example, an interaction with cyclosporin would need to be managed by a specialist. So just to confirm, this list is the active ingredients, which would mean that you must not take the standard dose of colchicine with them. And that's not just while you're taking one of these medicines, but also for 2 weeks after taking one of these medicines. Please also note that ritonavir is on this list, and it's one of the two essential active ingredients of an important antiviral medicine to fight COVID-19 infection with the brand name Paxlovid. So colchicine must not be taken with Paxlovid. And I would also like to bring to your attention that you should avoid eating or drinking grapefruit or grapefruit juice while you're on colchicine. Colchicine also has some other different types of interactions. So I'll put some info about these other types of interactions into the description section of this video for you. If you haven't already seen my part one video about colchicine, please make sure you watch it via this link, because it looks at who should not take colchicine, plus a range of important things to talk about with your doctor before you start colchicine, or if you're already taking colchicine. If you're interested in the fascinating way colchicine works, feel free to check out Colchicine, How Does That Work? Via the link I'll put into the description section for you. Please click the subscribe and like buttons below this video if you'd like to see more of these medicine safety videos. And also consider supporting us by buying merchandise from our official store on our pharmacistfi.com website. And Denver and I look forward to catching up with you again very soon here on this Pharmacist Fi Medicine Safety YouTube channel. Thanks for watching. Bye.